All right, in the previous video, we talked about how to install Python through Anaconda, and now let's see how we can basically code in Python, right? Okay, so we can open up our Jupyter Lab or Jupyter Notebook in two different ways, right? So the one way is to, if you're in a Windows, go to Start and then search for Anaconda Navigator. And if you're on Mac, again, do the same, you can search for the Anaconda in your applications, right? So let's go to sort menu and search for Anaconda, right? So this is, I type Anaconda and I get Anaconda Navigator, right? So you just click on it and it's going to open the entire platform for you, okay? So this is not the best way to work with Jupyter Notebook. And I just want to show it to you, and then after that, we're going to do it differently, right? So again, on my computer, it's wanting to update the Anaconda Navigator. So I'm just click on OK, remind me later. And then you can click on the Jupyter Lab or Jupyter Notebook. So for the purpose of this course, I'm going to type in everything in a notebook. We call it Python Notebook. And a Python notebook, I'm going to open one of them and explain to you what it is. But we're going to open our notebooks using Jupyter Lab, right? So Jupyter Lab is an IDE that helps us to write our Python code in an HTML environment. So this means that you can have the codes, you can have the inputs and output at the same time. And basically you can, it's really, really good for teaching purposes. So for that reason, I'm going to use Jupyter Lab, right? So again, one way is to click on launch in the Anaconda Navigator. And let's see, so it may take a couple of, not minutes, but less than that to open up for the first time. Okay, so depending on what's your default browser, so you're gonna see something like this. So for example, on my computer, my default browser is Chrome, Google Chrome. So, and there's new sheet opened up here. So the address is localhost. You'll see something like this on your computer as well, right? And then by default, it's going to open up to the folder that your Anaconda is installed on, right? So by default, it's in my, it's in the root of my computer, which is /users/ my last name, right? So yours is going to be different, right? So, and this is our Jupyter Lab environment. So we can make a new notebook in Python 3. We can open a console, we can open a terminal or text file or markdown. So again, you don't need to be worried about these things. The one that we are gonna use is basically open up a new Python. And then sometimes we're gonna use this contextual help, because this help is going to, as it sounds, it's going to help us with the attributes of a function, right? So for example, if you're using a function, you don't know what are the inputs, what are the features, we are going to use the help button. Okay, so that was one way to open up this Jupyter Lab. As I said, there is another way that I want you to recommend you to do it that way, because it's going to save some memory on your computer. So let me go ahead and close this one, and I'm going to go ahead and close this Anaconda Navigator. Okay, so the other way that I wanted you to do, again, on Windows and Mac is the same. On Mac, you're going to open up a terminal. On Windows, you open up a command window, right? So I press the window button and I just type CMD, standing for command prompt, and then press enter. Then here, it is important, right? So you can change the directory to whatever directory you want. And if you do not change the directory, it's going to open up to the default directory of Python, which is going to be your, again, username / your last name, whatever it is. So I'm going to go ahead and change the directory to D, because this is where I put my GitHub folder, right? So if you put your GitHub folder on, I don't know, on your C drive and then maybe on your download folder or whatever, So it's a good idea to just navigate to that folder first and then to open the Jupyter Lab, right? So this is the folder that in my D folder, I can look at the GitHub folder specifically. So let's look for GitHub. So when I do cd space, basically I'm going to a new directory, cd space, and then GitHub, and then if I press enter, I go to the GitHub folder. So this part, guys, on your computer, it is going to be some other directory, right? So maybe it's c/desktop or c/documents, downloads, and etc., right? Now, I am in the folder that I want to open my Jupyter Lab, right? So then I simply type Jupyter Lab, Jupyter space lab, and then press enter. So this is going to open up the Jupyter Lab for me in that specific folder, right? So which I put my GitHub account, right? So as you saw, this time it was open a lot faster than the previous time that I opened the Jupyter Lab through Anaconda, because as I said earlier, we're trying to save some memory on our computer, okay? All right, so these are the folders on my GitHub account. So on your computer, if you're using GitHub for the first time, most probably you're going to clone this repository, which is machine learning for the USU, and then maybe some other folders as well, right? But for sure, I expect that you see this one. And as I explained it in the previous video, in the GitHub video, I expect you to make a copy of this folder on your computer as well, right? So make a copy and play around with that one, right? So here, because I'm the owner of this folder on GitHub account, I'm going to open up this one directly. But on your computer, I expect you to see another folder named ml-usu-spring21 and hyphen your name, right? So play around with that. That folder is your sandbox, not this one, okay? And then when you go to the folder, so these are basically what you're going to see. Hopefully you're able to see something like this. Simply if you're navigating through my computer, right? So this part is very simple. So you can go to classes and then go to class 3, Python crash course. Then we go to notebooks. So here are our notebooks for the course, for the crash course, right? As you can see, the extension is IPYNB. Basically, it's IPython notebook, right? Because the codes are written in notebook language, right? So if I click on one of them, so for example, let's start, I'm going to start in a separate video going over all these 7 notebooks, but let me show you an example, and then I'll start from scratch, okay? So here's an example. If you double click on it, it's going to open up here. So basically, as you can see, these are, so for example, if you click on this logo, it goes to my website. And then this is a quick narration of what you're going to see in this notebook, right? So it's a Python crash course. In this notebook, we're going to talk about different data types, so numbers, strings, Boolean, and etc. I'm gonna spend some time in a separate video, right? So we are going to go over comparison operators and etc. And then these are, as you can see, there are 2 different cells, right? So one of them, you know, there are different cells, you know, we can type in them. And then there are some cells that we can type in Python language in them, right? So you can scroll down and see how we can write these codes. Again, that's the topic for the next video. But in general, this is what I mean by notebook, by Python notebook, right? So this is a notebook. It means that you can have your documentation, you can have your own words, you know, add some comments, and then at the same time run some codes and see the outputs, right? So we can see the code, we can see the output, we can see our own comments in on the same page, right? And you can add pictures, you can add URLs, and etc. So for example, if I scroll down, I think at the end of, well, not this, for the class lectures, at the end of each Python notebook, I add some the URLs. Basically, those are some the references for the topic of the course, right? Okay, so this was an example. So what if I want to open up a Python notebook from scratch, right? You can go ahead and click on this plus button. So basically it's a new launcher and it's asks you, what do you want to launch? So you want to create a new Python, and most probably you're going to see Python 3 on your computer only because Python 2 is expired. So if for whatever reason you have Python 3 from old, so it's not going to show up here because they expired Python 2. So you click on Python 3. So this is a new Jupyter, not necessarily Jupyter, this is a new notebook, right? Python notebook. So that's, as you can see, the name is untitled. So you can go ahead and right click on it and change the name. So for example, just rename it, say test or my first code, whatever. So now the name is test, right? So this is your notebook environment. So on the left, you have a navigation. So for example, what folder you are at, so you can look at the, so these are, when I click on this stop button, it basically says that what kernels are already running. And kernel means basically server. So this is a server that allows you to run your Python code on. So it says that I have two files already open and running. So the first one is Python basics, because this is already open it. The second one is test. So if you want to close some of your notebooks completely, it's not enough that you close it like this. So you have to close it and then you can go ahead and shut down that kernel, because it's, again, it's this is going to save you some memory. Okay. And then these are just cosmetic things. You can explore these things, you know, on your own pace, you know, just play around with them. But these are not something that we're going to use for. This is basically the settings, you know, you can look at, again, you can play around with all these things depending on what I type here. So these things are going to change. And basically this says that what do I have open? I have a launcher and a test open, right? So basically, most probably you're going to use the first tab here, which is what location are you at, right? This is important because sometimes you want to import some data sets from the folder. You have to make sure that whatever code you write here, you're importing from a folder. For example, if I want to import this GDP, this is a CSV, right? So let me double click on it and show it to you. So a cool feature of the Jupyter Lab compared to Jupyter Notebook is that you can double click on any type of files, right? So this is an Excel file, CSV file. I can see what is inside that file. So for example, this is a JPG file. It's a picture. I can take literally look at that. I can even open a PDF, right? So look at, for example, this is our Python crash course. This is a PDF, right? So this is really cool. You can use this interface as literally PDF opener, PowerPoint opener, Excel opener, and you name it, right? All right. So then, So basically, let's go back to our test. And so we were talking about this, whatever we have. Then if you go to file, so basically you can make a new folder and etc. So I guess you guys can easily figure out what are these things, right? So in files, we can again make a new notebook and etc. So these are the one that we're going to use is, sometimes we're going to save our notebook as HTML output, right? Or as a PDF, right? Usually it's not a bad idea to save your notebook as a HTML, because sometimes you are, I don't know, using another computer which doesn't have Python installed on it and you want to see what is inside that code. So if I do not have a Python on my computer which can open the IPy notebook file, extension file, it's a good idea to make it an HTML, and it can open HTML literally anywhere, right? Even on your cell phone. Okay. Then you can edit. So in the edit section, we're going to talk about basically doing some editing on the cells, right? So, and we will see what do I mean by cell. So it, do you see this box here? We call it a cell, right? So I can copy a cell, you know, paste it somewhere else, cut it, and things like that. You know, basically it's a simple word type of things, right? And then view, again, these are some cosmetic things. Run basically tells you what cell you want to run and etc. For all these things, we're going to use the shortcut keys, right? Because it really doesn't make any sense if I type something here 1+1 and then I go to the run and say, okay, run selected cell. This is kind of absurd, right? So I will learn the short key, the shortcut key, and then I'll use the shortcut key on my computer. I think I provided the cheat sheets for the shortcut keys on the Jupyter notebook as well. Please, again, make sure that you at least look at it once, and then as you practice it through time, it will become natural. It will look, hopefully it will become natural. That will become part of your muscle memory. All right. Then another thing is the kernel. So kernel is a server. So sometimes you're running a code and it's kind of stuck and you want to reset your kernel because, you know, it's been a while, you know, your computer is running for 10 minutes, nothing is going on, or you realize that you made a mistake, you want to stop a cell from running code. So you could come here and interrupt the kernel, right? So, or restart kernel and run all the cells, right? So this is something that we're gonna use as well. So I will focus on the things on the Jupyter notebook and Jupyter Lab that we're gonna use for the course, but this doesn't mean that, you know, you cannot explore different features on your own. Okay, then we have tabs, setting. Again, these are if you want to change any kind of settings. This, again, think of it as any kind of application on your computer. And basically help, so you can, whatever questions you have, you can think of the help button, right? So one thing that I highly encourage you to have in mind is how to use the short keys, and then to try to get used to using that contextual helper, right? So if I do Control B, it's going to close and open this left-hand side navigation, right? If I do Control I, it's going to open up contextual help, right? And then it's usually a good idea to have your contextual help, you know, I'm just clicking on it and then dragging it over, right? So I can add it at the bottom, I can add it to the right, and I can add it wherever I want, right? It's a good idea that have this contextual help on the right-hand side and then start coding on the left-hand side. Then whenever you're typing the name of a function, you will see some contextual help will show up on the right-hand side, right? But before doing that, we have to import some libraries and then we can use the functions from the libraries, right? So just this was a general introduction of what is Jupyter Notebook, why we're going to use it, and basically getting used to the interface of this. It's very simple and practical and straightforward. So I really like working with Jupyter Notebook, not only for my teaching purposes, you know, for my own sake, when I'm coding anything, I'm kind of used to it. I kind of used to work at Jupyter Notebook, which is really, really cool. All right, so let's stop here, and I'll see you in the next video. And basically, the next 7 videos, we're gonna go over every single of these Jupyter Notebooks and play around with them. All right, see you in the next one.